Yeah, good morning everyone. Yesterday we saw Indian markets crossing new high and giving a very good closing. And apart from that, even the US also had shown good performance and moved up sharply. Whereas in the Asian market also we are seeing some positiveness. On the other hand, commodity remained sideways. Oil continued to remain at around 72.5. Aluminium was flat and copper was down by around 1%. Iron ore was also flat. And steel, which was declining since last 2 days, had seen some bounce back. Now I request technical team to take up first.
Yes, thank you, sir. Good morning, all of you. This is Swati. Yesterday, finally, Nifty, almost after one and a half months, it has given a breakout of 16,000 psychological resistance level. And we have seen a fantastic rally towards 16,130-140 levels on the higher sides and maintained a very positive closing above the sims, which gives a positive sign into the market. Now, going ahead, Nifty is likely to touch the fit of 16,220 to 16,300 levels on the higher side. So this will be the first resistance zones. Today also the Nifty is likely to open on a gap up positions almost by 60 to 70 points on higher level. So we expect this rally to be continued towards 16,220 to 16,300 levels. Whereas on a downside, 16,070 will act as the immediate support zone. If it's break that level, then we can see some profit booking from the higher levels, which might take the Nifty towards 16,000 levels as well. So the overall view is definitely positive on the Nifty front, as it has given a breakouts of the resistance zones and moving on the upper side. Bank Nifty yesterday has closed above its 50 days moving average, which is showing also a positive sign on the technical part. I believe that this rally is likely to be extended towards 35,500 to 35,800 levels on the higher sides. Whereas on a downside, the immediate support lies at 35,000 will be the crucial psychological support zone. If it's break that level, then only we can see some soft momentums, or which might take a Nifty on a downside towards 34,700 to 34,600 levels. So going ahead, the overall view is positive on both the indices. Definitely the view is positive, but the higher level, one may see some profit bookings if it breaks the immediate support levels on the downsides. On the Nifty Finance side, 17,070 will be the immediate resistance zone. If it's break that level, then 17,150 to 17,200 levels can be seen. Whereas on a downside, the support is placed at 16,850. Any move below that level, we expect Nifty Finance to come down towards 16,720 to 16,600 levels. So these are the important support and resistance zone on the three indices. Stock specific, Siemens looks really good. On yesterday also we have initiated a buy call in this particular counter. We have seen a very positive pullback rally into the Siemens from the lower levels, or say from its support zone of 1900 levels. So those who are having any long positions, they can definitely still hold on with a stop loss of 2010. I'm looking for a target of 2060 on higher side. Godrej Consumer Product also looks really good on the technical setups. The stock is just moving in the pattern of higher tops, higher bottom formations. During a day, we might initiate a buy call in this particular counter. So one can just keep an eye on the Godrej Consumer Product. We believe that it has a potential to reach up to 1040 to 1050 levels on the higher sides. I think that's it from my end. I request derivative guys to take a call forward.
Yeah. Thank you, Swati. See, on the derivative front, looking at the overall position, the open interest yesterday has risen quite reasonably. Also, with the breakout yesterday, the data has changed for the positive, which is a very good sign. The 16,000 strike PCR is now above 1, which was not there for the last 8-9 weeks, which is a very big positive. Looking at the overall PCR OI, it has jumped from 1.25 or to 1.65 and entered the oversold zone, but it is still bullish, can still go to 1.8. So there are chances of Nifty moving up. Also, very importantly, this 16,300, 400, 500 strikes of the calls do not have much open interest built up amongst calls. And that is why, you know, we believe that Nifty can reach even further. There's not much built up, you know, people who have written puts are much more aggressive, and that is why the PCROI has gone up. That does mean that they believe that Nifty will not cross below the 16,000 levels, and the call writers are not very confident, and that is why you are seeing not much call writing going on in the 16,300, 400, 500 strikes, which is a very good sign for the market. So Nifty has in it to go towards the 16,400, 16,500 levels going forward. Looking at the stock specific front, see, again, very, very good breakout in the Nifty and the bank Nifty stocks as well. So PSU banks look very, very good at this particular point of time. The open interest in terms of rollovers was less, and they do not have large positions in it. And that is why I believe these stocks can actually perform very well along with the private sector banks. The private sector banks will now start to perform as well. So the likes of Axis Bank, ICICI, HDFC, Kotak, SBI, Canara Bank, these are the you know, banks now very likely to perform very well going forward. So one should buy banks in particular. That's it from my side. I'd like to ask the fundamental team to continue.
Good morning. Care Ratings result was okay. Revenue declined quarter on quarter in line with past trend at 38% from March quarter. Also, June quarter is seasonally weak, so much should not be read into it. Although on a year-on-year basis, the growth was 32%. We are positive from a long-term perspective. IIFL Wealth result was okay. Both revenue and EBITDA remained flattish on quarter-on-quarter basis. We are neutral over here. That's it from my side. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Yesterday, Porsche came with all the results, and results were declining. It's a chemical manufacturing company. Tata Consumer Products announced their results, and results were marginally above expectations, mainly because of the EBITDA margins, which came at 13% versus, against the expectation of 12%. The domestic business is doing good, and also the tree prices have started moderating, so that should do well for them. Pratap Snacks announced the results, and results were above expectations. The sales grew by 43% YoY, and the margins were at 4% versus expectation of 1.7%. However, the company continued to report losses at the PAT level. Newland Laboratories announced the results, and results were declining. This is the second consecutive quarter where the results were not good. However, the management has said that this is an outlier, and they see margins to go back to their 20% mark, which they reported around 12-13% in this quarter. However, they have not given any timeline. The stock reacted negatively yesterday and was down 5% at lower circuit. We expect some more negative reaction to continue. Kazaria Ceramics announced the results, and results were below expectations. Though sales grew by 100% on the very low base, the margins came at 14% versus expectation of 17%. Dabur India announced the results, and results were really good, but much above the expectations. Also, the volume growth was very good at 34% versus expectation of 17%. And the management also maintained their positive demand outlook. Barbecue Nation announced their results, and results have declined because we can understand because there were so many lockdowns during this quarter. Nosil announced their results, and results have improved. The sales grew by 200% again on the low base, and we have seen that the last year auto were not doing so well. However, they started recovering. The margins also improved to 21% versus 16% last quarter and 7.5% last year. We continue to remain positive on this, and this is one of the top pick in our SSLP portfolio. Alkyl Amines announced the results, and results were below expectation. However, we have seen that the stock has moved quite a lot in recent past, and now it is trading around 72 times FY22, which we believe is quite on the higher side. Today there are four IPOs which are opening up. I'm covering two of them now. One is Exaro Tiles. Exaro Tiles is into tile manufacturing, and they're mainly into double charred verified and glazed verified tiles. They have around exports of around 14%. They have two manufacturing sites. The sales has been growing around 5% CAGR in last 3 years. We believe that we are recommending avoid on this, mainly because they have very high working capital, which is around 200 days. And even the return ratios are very low at 11% and 13% ROE and ROC respectively. Also, the PE, the company is asking at the upper band of 120 rupees is 35 times FY21 earnings, which we believe is on the higher side. That is why we are recommending avoid on this issue. Another one is Devyani International. They are the largest franchisee of Yum brands like KFC, Pizza Hut, and they also have Costa Coffee under their portfolio. This has been promoted by Jaipuria Group, which also hold the franchisee for the Pepsi bottling in the name of Varun Beverages. Their core brand business, which is KFC, Pizza Hut, and Costa, is doing well. And among that also, KFC is the mainly growing very well. They follow their cluster-based approach. We are positive on this company and recommending buy. The price band is 86 to 90 rupees. And at 90 rupees, the EV, we are recommending on EV by sales because it is a loss-making company. However, they have recently made changes to their portfolio. So we believe that with this and the repayment of the debt from the IPO proceed, they can turn positive in near future. So as I was saying, on EV by sales, this comes to around 9.8 on FY21 sales, and which is comparable to other listed players. So that is why we are recommending buy on this. There are two small news. Dr. Reddy has relaunched OTC naproxen sodium tablets, which is marginal positive. It has a $315 million size. Natco Pharma has transferred generic Revlimid ANDA to its marketing partner, Aero International, as per an earlier agreement between parties. This is marginal negative because this was a big drug for them, and people were quite positive on the prospects of this. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Inox Leisure has continued to post weak set of numbers for the quarter. Nitin Spinners has posted improved set of numbers both on the revenue and the margin front. Other than this, Endocount Industries has posted improved set of numbers both on the revenue and the margin front. Share is trading at a PE of 17.5 times FY22 EPS. Thank you.
Yeah, good morning. Another IPO, Krishna Diagnostics Limited. The company is one of the largest diagnostic service providers in India. They provide technology and services such as.
Ravish, your voice is not clear.
Hello?
Yeah, it is better.
Yeah. So, Krishna Diagnostics Limited opens today. It is one of the largest. Diagnostic service provider in India. They provide services including radiology, pathology, and clinical laboratory and radiology services. The company is mainly into the PPP, which has posted good numbers, and is going forward. This market is at a CAGR of 14 to 17%. Between FY18 and 21, the company's revenues grew at a CAGR of 54%, while EBITDA grew at 50%. The price band is 933 to 954 rupees. The company has around 50 crores as on FY21, which will be from the IPO close, thereby reducing the interest liability in future. And with the company has healthy balance sheet and robust revenue growth, and we recommend subscribing. Thank you.
Yeah, this was more for Krishna Diagnostic. No doubt the voice was not voice was a bit blur. We are recommending to subscribe the issue. It's in diagnostic business, and not like Dr. Lal or Metropoli. It's more of a B2B business. They take tender work from government hospitals. And there they do the work, they set up their imaging centers and all, and do get money from government. No doubt financials are not like the leading player like Dr. Lal and Metropoli, but still they're doing well. And the valuations asked is also comparatively lower as compared to the other player. So one can look to subscribe to the issue. Apart from that, one another issue, Vindla's IPO is opening. The price band is 448 to 460. Issue size is 560 crores. They are into mainly pharmaceutical outsourcing business or CRAM business, contract manufacturing business. They do manufacturing for other leading brands and all. It's more of a B2B player where they don't have any direct sales, and CRAMP is also for Indian market and not for the international market. So it's such a very generic player, nothing so great in the company, and even the valuation they are asking is quite steep. So we are not recommending this IPO. Apart from that, Godrej Property came up with the number, and the numbers were not so good. The fresh booking was only 497 crores versus last quarter 2632 crores and last year 1500 crores. But management has given positive commentary in booking of around 500 crore, around 300 crore came in June month. And July also, they indicated that they itself has done around 500 crore of booking. Overall, for the year, they are looking at a very good launch pipeline, and also the booking is also expected to be quite strong and higher than the last year. For price increase, they had indicated that in Bombay market, they are not yet seeing any price increase up till now. But if this trend continues, then the price increase may be seen in another 6 months. Whereas in DLF, we had already seen the price increase has started in the Delhi market. So maybe Bombay is lagging in price increase and maybe coming in after 3 to 6 months. Apart from that, Dhampur Sugar came up with the numbers, and the numbers were okay. In fact, this time sugar companies are not reporting so great number, mainly because of the early closure of crushing, because they had started early and ended early. And because of that, the working factory days in this quarters are lower, and that is resulting into lower power earning, and even the sugar earning also, their profitability getting impacted because of the higher overhead cost. And that's why revenue from sugar and power divisions are lower, and profitability is also lower, whereas profitability in ethanol division is strong and has moved up sharply. So overall, negated by decline in sugar and power with higher earning in ethanol. So overall result seems okay. Nothing so great in this right now. Apart from that, another company which came up with the numbers are Bharti Airtel. The numbers came ahead of expectations. Marginally ahead of expectations, mainly on account of increasing ARPU. Expectation was of 145 rupees, but it came at 146 rupees. African business has given a strong performance. India business, data business has given strong performance, whereas we had seen that there were decline of subscriber in May month, but overall for the quarter it seems positive trend. So definitely June quarter must be seeing positive addition in their subscriber. So overall result seems marginally ahead of expectations. And considering that recently they were able to do some jiggery into their pricing for the lower pack, which may result into higher ARPU in the coming quarter. And the competitor is not able to remain competitive and facing a lot of financial problems. So quite possible Bharti may gain on that account. So the outlook on Bharti Airtel is positive. So then Adani Port also came up with the numbers, and the numbers were ahead of expectations. And Adani Enterprises results were okay. So that's all from us. Thank you very much and have a good day.
Subscribe to our YouTube channel for in-depth interviews of India Inc. and press the bell icon so that you do not miss our updates.